now I can go backwards, make a spectral curve. If there would be a sub-vector bundle preserved by this, it would give a spectral curve, which is a sub curve of this. But this I'm looking at the smooth fibers. So this is a smooth complete fiber. It doesn't have subcurves. So if I start with a line bundle here, any line bundle, maybe the vector bundle is not stable, but the pair is stable. Yes? Do I have time to write it down? So, note, P lower star of LA need not be stable. This explains why pi inverse P big P inverse of A so need not be the entire Jacobian, but always stable P star L with phi is always stable. Any sub, any line bundle, any sub bundle preserved by phi has its own spectral curve. So the, by the way, these CAs are called spectral curves for the obvious reason, because it parameterizes the spectrum of phi. Its own spectral curve. So it has to be CA and not a proper part. So this is the reason why you have to, if you want to have something complete, you have to look at pairs. And now maybe I should give an example. Ah, okay. I need to do two things. First thing is an example showing you that it can fail. And secondly is how prim varieties come up. Namely, I take a rank 2 bundle in the case of SL, so an SL2 bundle, on GS2 curve, and I take simply for L is a line bundle of degree equal to 1, and I take the vector bundle EL, which is L plus L dual, and then I fix x0, where x0 is fixed point on C. Now, this vector bundle is unstable. And because the degree is 1, and it is bigger than 1/2, because the determinant is 1, and the determinant has rank 1, and you have to divide this by the rank, so it's bigger than 1/2, so it's unstable. However, if I look at traceless endomorphisms, global traceless endomorphisms, they look like A, B, C minus A, where A, as before, varies in the E0 omega. But B and C, they vary in certain line bundles, which you can make explicit. But such a phi, well, when does it fix L? When C is zero. So, because C varies in a line bundle which has sections, you can make the calculations, this is one dimensional, a generic section will have C non-zero. If C is non-zero, then EL phi will be stable. So you see, so in the simplest case, it already does go wrong, and it goes wrong badly. And what Hitchin does, he makes certain calculations from which he concludes that in the rank 2 case, the bad locus, so the locus in the moduli space, which I have not been spoken about, but if you take the moduli space MG, which is the moduli space of stable pairs, modulo equivalence, then in this moduli space, the things that come from stable vector bundles, they form an open set with complement of codimension 2. Well, he claims even G, but I was not able to see that. But 2 is probably enough. But it's nowhere, I saw nowhere in the literature that for n bigger rank, this is also true. It should be true, but it's maybe a good exercise for a doctoral student, or not a doctoral student, but a master's thesis or so. It's not obvious to me. I never saw, didn't see it in the literature. Also, I don't know whether it's used in the article.
The codimension.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes, I think it is.
Oh, well, yeah. Then you should locate. Even in Nitsura, which is very algebraic, there's no mention.
I think it might be in Ngo, perhaps.
Maybe, but that I didn't check. That I didn't check. Okay, so the reference was to Hitchin, and Hitchin only does it for rank 2 vector bundles on any genus curve, but not for higher. And I didn't see an obvious reason why it should go on for higher. Because he proves it really by classification of all the non-stable vector bundles. And this is awkward. I mean, you can do it for low rank, but not in general. Okay, let me quickly finish by saying where the prim varieties come from. Well, you have map from the spectral curve to the curve of genus G.